All right, finally time to punch. We get a punch needle. Isn't that exciting? So before we start on our design, we are going to just do a couple lines outside of our design. And the reason for that is I have found that people are scared to ruin their punch needle project. And so they will not pay attention to what they're learning and focus more on their lines and their tool. So we're just going to pick any spot on your canvas. We're gonna pull the yarn out, so don't worry about that. And you can still use the same fabric. That's the beauty of punch needle. So we're gonna pick our lines and we're going to insert our punch needle into the fabric, just like that. And rule number one, punch needle handle, the tip of your handle always touches the fabric. Very important. Always, always, always touch your handle to your fabric. Now we're gonna pull our yarn tail out, just like this. You're always gonna want your yarn tail on the side of your loops. So we pull the yarn tail out. And then when we go to our next stitch, just go over a couple holes. It doesn't, two or three holes. Mine doesn't matter. And you graze the fabric with the tip of your needle. Don't lift your needle too high, because that will create uneven loops, links, and it might even pull your yarn out. Graze the tip of your needle across your fabric. Punch two or three holes in, handle to fabric. Lift it up slightly, not too high. Graze your fabric, insert again, handle to fabric. Graze, handle to fabric. Another very, very important tip is to leave your yarn tail loose. If this is trapped at all, it won't allow the yarn to stay inside your fabric. So you wanna make sure this is always, always, always loose. You wanna make sure your handle always touches the fabric, and you're gonna wanna make sure that the tip of your needle grazes the fabric. And those are the keys, the three keys to punch needle: loose yarn tail, handle to fabric, graze the tip. Each and every time. Each and every time. And when you turn it over, you should have very even loops, just like that, that have a little bit of a gap in between. And that is normal. You want the gaps, because if your yarn loops are too close together, then it will create bunching and it will lose the detail of your punch needle piece. So we leave the gaps in between our loops, just like this. And then our next row, we will offset that gap and it'll fill in. So it'll all take into place. And then to turn the corner, we're going to leave our needle inside the fabric, turn the fabric, or turn your piece, and then do the same thing. Lift your needle slightly, do not lift it too high, and then you will go into the mountain of your last row. So where your yarn is inside the fabric is your valley. The mountain is the top of the stitch. So to offset it, you're basically gonna go in the valley of your last stitch. So go inside the mountain tip of your stitch. Handle to fabric, loose yarn tail, graze the tip in the middle of your last stitch, which I call the mountain, the top of the mountain, in the middle. Handle to fabric, graze the tip, loose yarn tail. Those are the keys. That's right there. That's the key to punch needle. So if you offset your stitches properly, you will see that they just kind of have a little step ladder there. So that looks really good. That's a really good stitch right there. And that's, so they'll fill in, but yet they won't be too close that they'll be too filled, and you won't lose the detail in your piece. So again, to turn, we leave the needle inside the fabric, turn the needle so it's facing the way you want to go, and then you will just go to your next row and offset your stitches in the middle of the mountain on your next row. And it is the next row. So the monk's cloth has rows. You will pretty much go every single row, but you'll offset the columns. So one more time, we'll turn the needle. Needle, yarn tail is loose. We graze the tip, go inside the mountain, and Handle touches the fabric each time. Graze the tip. Handle touches the fabric. 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 Graze tip. Handle fabric. Loose yarn tail. And that's it. And then I'll teach you, and then to end this one, you can simply just pull out your yarn tail and cut it off. And then you can take it out. And that is how you punch needle. Yay! You did it!